Bishop, they said to my father, to my champion, to my idol, to my mentor, your son is not going to graduate. My father came home very quiet, and when he's quiet, I know something's wrong. He still made dinner. We sat there. He asked me how was school. I said, like it is all the time. Y'all in the quiet section over there. He said, how you doing in class? And I've never been a liar, really. So I said, I really can't tell you. He said, are the classes too difficult for you? I said, absolutely not. He said, well then, why are you flunking and will not graduate? I said, now, Reverend. I'm sorry if y'all ain't close to your family. I said, Reverend, because I got to make him laugh before I tell him what I'm going to tell him. You got to break him down. But when your parents are serious, you got to crack a joke or make a face so that they don't beat you as bad. They'll be like, don't make me laugh because I'm serious right now. You know, you have to do that. Don't ever get as serious as the one with the weapon. Don't. I said, now, Reverend, I said, now, who told you that I'm not going to graduate? He said, Todd, this ain't time to play. I said, Reverend, if graduating will make you proud of me, I'm going to graduate. He said, yeah, you're going to graduate in summer school. I said, no, I'm not. I am going down, y'all miss me, that platform with my class. He said, school is over. You're going into final exam week. And if you ain't reading this book, and if you ain't been in class and ain't took no test. Now, Reverend, you ain't got to yell, we ain't in church. Todd, I'm not playing with you. I'm so hurt because you're an intelligent. I said, go on now, praise me a little bit. Tell me some of the good stuff. You're my most intelligent son. I trust you. Talk a little more because I need to be praised to perform. Y'all, I'm going to talk, Reverend. I'm glad I got some folk who heard bedtime stories when you were a child. And he always told me I was joking, but I always made him laugh. I said, go on and praise me now. Tell me I'm smart. Tell me I'm the smartest person in Roseville High School. He said, you're the smartest person in Roseville High School. Then I saw him cry, and that did it. So the next day, his words, his praise stuck with me so much that it made me go to the man in charge and work out a deal. I cannot accept failure. My principal Smith said, well, you can pass in the summer. I said, no, I need to pass now. He said, the school year is over. You have missed 18 classes. You have taken no exams. We're about to enter finals. How are you going to pass? Then here comes Dean Brown. See, y'all, Dean Brown comes in. Jim Brown says to my principal, he said, now, you know what? Let's see if he's serious. Todd Hall, we will cut you a deal. He's laughing at me. He says, if you pass every final with over 80, we'll let that be your grade. I said, write that right in here. Now, I need you to write. I didn't go to class. I'm about to close it because, number one, I'm bored because I'm sitting among average people. Y'all mighty quiet because people are only jealous of the person that makes a difference. So when you're a loud praiser, you got 8 folk looking at you like you're retarded. But the thing is, I'm not you. Now, When I went to school, I graduated college because I did all of my dissertations in praise, on the topic praise. That's why I'm a praiser. It helped me get out of school. It helped me get a degree. It helped my bills get paid. It helped me pass high school. And if any Negro want to challenge me in the subject of praise, let's get it on. Because I tell you, praise is not emotionalism. It is what moves God every day. Every single day. That's why he made a group of angels that their only job with six wings, a freak. Y'all need to, because praises are a freak of nature. He makes a six winged angel, two to veil their feet, two to cover their face, and with two they fly away. But they can only praise headed in his direction. Because when you're a praiser, you got easy access. When you're not, you got to hustle. Lord, 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 I got to go. Lord. Sit. So I took the test. I passed all my tests with nothing less than a 95. Right? So the dean, the one who announced that I wasn't graduating, the one who played me to the left in front of my principal but signed a legal document, got so upset that he made me take the test over in his presence. And right now, if 10 folk catches, we there. And right now, the devil know you passed, but he's done accused you and got you sitting in a private class. Y'all ain't, oh, y'all. Trying to tell God you cheated. You got everything wrong. So God said, let him take the test now, right in my face. That is. And if they pass this exam, they gonna graduate with honors. Y'all ain't talking. My whole class was jealous when my name was called because they didn't see me among them. I graduated, I walked across that class, tipped my tassel and flung my hat. My father was crying. He showed up from work because he thought I was playing because I didn't tell him until the day of graduation. I said, Reverend, where you at, Todd? Stop playing. You home? Home. I said, you better hurry up and get on that train. My father said, what you talking about? I said, I'm graduating in 2 hours. Boy, you are not, because I didn't tell him that I wrote the deal. I didn't tell him I took the test. He said, are you serious? Put your principal on the phone. I said, my daddy won't talk. He said, Mr. Hall, Todd is graduating with honors. We worked the deal. My father hung up. He said, your father hung up. Father zoomed there crying. He came to me. I said, you know why I passed? He said, tell me. Because you said I'm the most intelligent, oldest son you ever had. And when you praise God, it makes him forget your failures. And he starts working on you in a whole new way.